In this video, I'm going to show you how to record internal computer audio as an MP3 file on a Windows PC. Just make sure to watch to the very end so you don't miss anything. Let's go. All right, let's jump right in. First, go to audacityteam.org and download the latest version of Audacity, which is a free open source audio editing tool. Make sure you select the download without Muse Hub option, as we don't need that. If you already have Audacity installed, just go to help and check for updates to make sure you have the latest version. Once it's installed, launch it, and if you're greeted with this prompt, just click disable UUID to turn off usage tracking. If you're shown this cloud setup dialog, again, we don't need that. Just click don't show this again at startup and click the X to close. Now we're ready to set up our audio and record. First, click audio setup, then host, and select Windows WASAPI, which is the native Windows audio pipeline. Then just make sure your headphones are plugged in if you plan to use them, and click audio setup and then rescan audio devices. Then click audio setup, recording device, and here we're going to choose the device we want to capture the audio from. In other words, we're going to capture the audio that's coming out of your speakers or headphones. The best way to determine what to choose is to open up Control Panel, Hardware and Sound, and click Manage Audio Devices. And then if you play some audio, right in here, you'll see the audio coming through the device that you need to choose. So in my case, I need to choose Speakers Realtek Audio. Now this could be your headphones, speakers, whatever you have selected as your default device. So in Audacity, I'll choose Audio Setup, Recording Device, Speakers Realtek Audio. Then open Audio Setup, Playback Device, and choose that same device so we can listen to our recording when we're done. All right, setup is done and now we're ready to record. So I'll just click the record button and pull up some example audio and hit play. Okay, when you're done, just hit stop. And here you can see that we've successfully captured the audio. Just click anywhere in the middle and hit play to preview it. So far, so good. So now we just need to trim this blank space off. Click the selection tool, select the areas to remove, and press the delete key. So now we have our full clip. The last step before we export is to make sure that the audio is loud enough. When we record, it actually uses the volume coming out of your speakers or headphones, which might be lower than we want in the actual recording. It might be a little too quiet, but we can easily fix this in Audacity. Select the clip by clicking the header for it, then open the Effect menu, Volume and Compression, and choose Normalize. You can just keep the default settings here and then click Apply. This brings the audio up to a standard volume without distorting it. And now we're ready to export. Just click File, Export Audio, Export to Computer, and choose the MP3 file's format. Give it a file name here. I'll just make it output.mp3 and choose where you want to save it. I'll just save it to my desktop. Optionally, if you click Edit Metadata, you can add some details about the recording if you'd like. Then when you're ready, click Export. When it's done, you can just double click the file to preview your new masterpiece. Now I know that was a lot, so here are all the steps in one place and you can just pause here if you need to. By the way, if you're getting value out of this video, hit like, subscribe, and tap the notification bell to get more valuable content like this. Now, for some people, an error can pop up when you try to record. The error usually says error code 9996 invalid device or error code 9997 invalid sample rate. This usually means that your audio settings in Audacity need to be tweaked a little bit to further match the recording device. First, open Control Panel, Hardware and Sound, and Manage Audio Devices. Then right-click your default device and choose Properties. Then choose Advanced. Now back in Audacity, open Audio Setup and then Audio Settings. Make sure that the quality settings in Audacity match the default format here for your device. So I want to set this to 24-bit and 48K Hertz so it matches. And then click OK and see if you can record now. If it still doesn't work, you can open Audio Setup and make sure that the number of recording channels is correct. Usually it's 2 for normal stereo speakers, but this can be even higher for fancy headphones or a surround sound system. So try tweaking the number of channels and see if that fixes the issue. If it records fine, but you're hearing feedback like this, just open the edit menu, preferences, recording, and make sure the hear other tracks and audible input monitoring settings are unchecked, and then click OK. And finally, if all else fails and it just won't record with your chosen device, you can always try using a different playback device in sound settings. So I'll just play some audio, and now in sound, just right click the other device, maybe other speakers or headphones, click set as default device, and here we can see it's switched over. Now be sure to set the recording device and playback device to this new selection in Audacity, just like we did before. And here we can see it's now recording from that other device. So now you can record computer audio on a Windows PC. If this video helped, leave a comment below. Now, if you want to record your microphone along with the computer audio, then you'll want to check out this video next. And to learn how to screen record with computer audio, check out this video next. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.